In my last video, I touched on how to grow and widen the front arms by focusing on the biceps. But that's only one side of the arm. Filling out your shirt sleeves also comes down to having bigger triceps, which makes up around 2/3 of the size of your arms. In order to grow the triceps, you need to have an understanding of its anatomy, the best exercises that emphasize each of its heads, and the correct way to perform these exercises to train each head effectively. In this video, I'll lay all this down for you to help you maximize your triceps gains and improve your arms' aesthetics. Coming up. The triceps muscle group is composed of three heads: the long head, the medial head, and the lateral head. The long head, located towards the back of your arm, is the biggest of them all, making alone around 2/3 of the mass of the triceps, which makes it the most essential for creating that overall appearance of your arm size. The smaller medial and lateral heads combined together constitute the remaining 1/3. While isolating the three heads from each other may be difficult since they collectively work together, many bodybuilders are unaware that changing the angle of the arm and the grip can stress each head differently. They seem to lack the understanding of how various exercises hit their triceps, which may cause them to overemphasize one triceps head over the other and miss out significant gains. While all three triceps heads cross the elbow joint and are responsible for elbow extension, many lifters don't emphasize the long head effectively because they don't know that it is the only triceps head that crosses the shoulder joint, which means it can also assist in shoulder extension and can be preferentially targeted from different angles for more growth. According to analysis by Landon and Thompson, greater degrees of shoulder flexion elicit greater stretch on the long head. This becomes important when you perform the overhead triceps exercises in order to maintain and maximize tension on the long head. For example, when performing the skull crusher or inclined dumbbell extension, allowing the bar or dumbbell to come fully straight over your head takes significant tension off the long head. Instead, you should further flex your shoulder by moving and keeping your arm slightly back to maintain the tension and elicit greater stretch on the long head throughout the entire range of motion. To further activate the long head, you should also include exercises that extend your arms behind your body, like the inclined dumbbell kickbacks. To reap full benefits of the exercise, you need to ensure it is executed correctly in proper form. Number one, keep your elbows locked to the sides and your upper arms parallel with your body throughout the movement. Number two, many lifters make this common mistake of using too much weight when performing this exercise. Instead, choose a weight that's light enough for you to fully extend your arm back through its full range of motion without using momentum or cheating. You should be able to extend your arm until it's parallel to the floor to elicit maximum stretch of the long head. Now, while it's impossible to isolate the medial and lateral heads completely, you can still include or manipulate exercises in your routine to emphasize one head over the other. Although the medial head assists more in all triceps lifts as the arms reach full extension, it can be favored more with exercises that utilize more of a supinated forearm with an underhand grip, such as the reverse grip pushdowns. Furthermore, according to EMG analysis by researcher Brett Contreras, when a rope is used instead of a bar for the pushdowns, the medial head becomes more engaged. Exercises that utilize more of a pronated forearm with an overhand grip focus more on the lateral head, such as the straight bar pushdowns, bench dips, and close grip push-up. Now, when performing the pushdowns, it's vital that you pay close attention to your form. Standing upright and too close to the cable limits range of motion and reduces tension on the triceps, since line of resistance from the cable becomes more parallel to the forearm. Moving the elbows excessively forward engages your lats and shifts tension away from the triceps. Slowly leaning forward and flaring the elbows out, which normally happens when fatigue sets in, shifts tension away from your triceps to your chest and shoulders. To perform the pushdown exercise correctly, move a small step away from the cable, stick your chest up and out, retract your shoulder blades, and pin the elbows to the sides, and maintain this position as you perform each rep. Make sure you extend your arm until full lockout at the bottom. Since your triceps are primarily composed of type 2 muscle fibers and are best stimulated with heavy weight, you should include compound exercises like the close grip bench press or the weighted bar dip, which both emphasize the medial and lateral heads and can be overloaded with more weight over time. To perform the close grip bench press correctly, grab the barbell in a bulldog grip with your hands around shoulder width apart. Do not take a closer grip as this shifts tension off the triceps and may strain your wrists as you bring the bar down. Before unracking the bar, make sure your feet are on ground, your shoulder blades are retracted, and your back is slightly arched. As you perform each rep, bring the bar down towards your sternum, but without letting it touch your body, and always keep your elbows close to your sides. As you push the bar back up using your triceps, lock your arms at the top. To perform the bar dip exercise correctly, keep your chest up and your body as vertical as possible, since leaning forward shifts tension away from the triceps to the chest. Lower yourself down until your shoulders are parallel with your elbows, and then press back up until your arms are fully locked out. Now you may be wondering whether you should be performing all the exercises mentioned in this video every week. The answer is definitely no. This is because your triceps are indirectly engaged in your compound pressing movements, and adding excessive volume from triceps exercises may become counterproductive for recovery and hypertrophy. Instead, I suggest including one overhead exercise and one kickback exercise for the long head, as this muscle contributes most to the size of your triceps, and one compound exercise targeting both the lateral and medial heads, or two isolation exercises, one for each head. It is recommended that you begin your workout with the heavy compound exercises first to be able to perform them with full energy to stimulate more hypertrophy, then move into exhausting your muscles with isolation exercises. To keep challenging your triceps over time, progressively overload your compound lifts and mix up your exercises every 1 month or two. Thank you guys for watching. If you're struggling in building bigger triceps, let me know your challenges and any clarifications you have in the video by leaving a comment below. If you like this video, please like and share, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button. If you're looking for a complete self-educational training guide that teaches you step by step how to customize your workout and meal plans using science-based methods to optimize your results, please visit my website or check the video linked up. Also, check my next two videos on how to build bigger biceps and how to overhead press properly for bigger shoulders.